Hello there, welcome to part 1 of this tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make the Chrome Dinosaur game using the Godot game engine. Let's get started. First things first, creating the main scene. This can be done by selecting a node 2D and renaming it main. That easy. Next up, the player. First, create a kinematic body 2D. Then, add a sprite and collision shape to the body. For now, we'll use the default sprite. Make sure the collision shape fits perfectly around the sprite. This will be our player. Remember to save branches scene, and open it up. Next, we'll need to map out a button. Go into the project settings and click on input map. This will allow you to map out which buttons will be used for the game. I will be using the space bar for the jump. After this, you'll need to add a script to the player. This will consist of things like gravity, jump height, player movement, etc. Start by making the gravity variable and jump variable. Finally, make the velocity variable. Next, make a physics process function for player input. Add the jump key. In order for the player to move upwards, the velocity must be subtracted from the jump height. Because movement is on the y-axis, we must use .y. After this, multiply the gravity and delta. Add move and slide so that the player can move along an axis and collide with objects. Looks like the player is able to fall. But we're not done yet. Now that the player has gravity, we need to add the floor. Let's do this by using Tilemaps and adding collision. This will be our ground. Once this is set up, create a new tile set. The size of the cell is a little too big. I want the cell to be about half the size. You can change the size of the cell by adjusting the cell size. Looks good. Now, click on Tile Set and import an image. Select New Single Tile. In order to add collision, you must select a region. Make sure the snap options are the same as the cell size. Now you can click and drag the floor. As you can see, the player can collide with the ground. However, they can't jump. We can fix this by going into the script. At the beginning of the function, we need to add is on ground. This will allow for jumping as long as there is collision. Now we can jump. Let's increase the gravity. I'm going to increase this to 500. This looks good, but the gravity seems to be a little bit too high. You can play around with the variables to fit your needs. I will increase both my gravity and jump height. Nice. There is only one thing left to cover, and that is scrolling backgrounds. Thankfully, this process is very easy. In order to create a scrolling background, you need to add a parallax background. Attach a parallax layer. Then add a sprite. I'll rename this background. I will be using another placeholder as the background. Wonderful artwork, I made it myself. It should fit neatly in the frame. Next, I'll add a script to the background. Create a physics process function. Add scroll base offset for movement. To change the scroll speed, increase or decrease the X value. I'll set the X value to 60, so that the background moves a little slower. Now, I'll need to add mirroring so that the image scrolls infinitely. Increase the X value until both images are side by side. All set. Let's see if it works. What? Looks like I forgot to subtract from the assignment. This is important, as it allows the background to move left. Perfect. Nice. As you can see, the background image moves left. Now you have a scrolling background. Thanks for watching. I'm looking forward to continuing this project. If you enjoyed, why not stick around? Have a good day. Bye.